Hello all of you, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'll be explaining you about the factors affecting the strength of hardened concrete. So we have around 11 factors which influence the strength of the concrete. So let's get into the factors in detail one by one. So right now you can see on the screen we have the following factors which drastically show their influence on the strength parameters of concrete. We have water cement ratio, compaction of concrete, the ingredients means the constraint materials what we are using to manufacture the concrete, curing of concrete, the shape of the aggregates we are using, the maximum size of aggregate we are using, also the grading of aggregate we are using, in the sense what type of grading we are preferring or what is to be preferred. Next, weather conditions or environmental factors, temperature, rate of loading means the rate of application of load, and also the age of the concrete. Let's see how all these 11 factors are influencing the strength of the concrete. First one is the water cement ratio. What is water cement ratio generally? Water cement ratio means it is the weight of the water to the cement content. So when we decide generally a water cement ratio for a particular mix, so when we say W, we generally denote by W by C. So when we fix a water cement ratio of say some 0.45, so W by C will be equal to 0.45. So from there we will get, or we need to calculate the W, which will be equal to 0.45 into C. Okay, like this we will be calculating. Once you know the cement content, you can calculate the amount of water required to prepare that concrete mix. So how is this water cement ratio influencing the strength of the concrete? Always remember, how much less is your water cement ratio, that much more will be the strength. Water cement ratio and strength are always inversely proportional to each other. Low is the water cement ratio, high will be the strength. Even this statement is also called as Abraham's law. Even Abraham has stated the same thing. So for less water cement ratios, we have less workability, but less workability will give us high strength. Okay, so minimum water cement ratio required for hydration is 0.38. so from 0.38 up to 0.6, whatever water cement ratio based on your design and based on your purpose you can select, but mostly used water cement ratios will start from 0.4. and when you are extending or when you're going beyond 0.45 like that, you can reduce the water content by adding a plus sizer or a super plus sizer. Okay, always remember, we are trying to reduce the water content, but still we are replacing the workability or consistency of the concrete with the help of plus sizes or super plus sizes, because to stop the problem or to prevent the problem of segregation and bleeding. If there is more water, of course the workability is more, of course the mobility of the concrete is more, but there is a problem of segregation and also there is a problem of bleeding. So water cement ratio and strength are always inversely proportional to each other. So even in this graph you can observe, water cement ratio is on the x-axis, you have compressive strength on the y-axis. You can see how it's falling down. As you are increasing the water cement ratio, you can see how the strength of the concrete is coming down. Second factor is compaction of concrete. So this is a very out of common sense itself, we can say. If you do not compact your concrete properly, what will happen? The air voids does not come outside from the concrete. So when the air voids are less, what will happen? Obviously the strength will be less. These air voids will become the source of entry of carbon dioxide from the oxygen, salts from water, etc. Thereby you are disturbing your concrete. So voids doesn't impart you strength. Our concrete should be as dense as possible. So proper compaction is always ensured. You have to always compact the concrete. You can see here in the second point, approximately 5% of air voids can reduce the strength by 30 to 40%. So if you neglect compaction, you would obviously land in less strength results. So always a fully compacted concrete specimen will give high strength when compared to insufficiently compacted concrete. More is the compaction, more will be the strength. So this person is using a pin vibrator to compact. Next comes ingredients of concrete. What are the ingredients we use in concrete generally? we use cement, sand, aggregate and water. Just a conventional concrete or a nominal mix. Let's not go for any special concrete, general concrete. It requires cement, sand, aggregate and water, right? So here I am talking aggregate means coarse aggregate. Why? Because I've already written sand. One has to be very careful with the quality of these constituent materials you are using. If any compromise in quality of any of these material, obviously the strength of the concrete finally will go down. Every material is to be tested for its quality. They should stand by the IS code specifications, then only you can use them. It's not that it's cheaply available, it's you are getting of low cost, it's readily available, you can't use it. It should satisfy all the code specifications, its respective code specifications. Why? Because quality of individual material also can affect the entire strength of the concrete. Okay, so all the materials, whatever you are using, it should satisfy all the standard criteria it is meant for. It should, and these materials quality will depend upon the, in the sense when you're talking about cement, it will depend upon the type and quantity of the cement. When you're talking about aggregates, it depends upon the type and quantity of the aggregates, both fine and coarse. When you're talking about water, what quality of water you are mixing in the concrete, that is also very, very careful, okay? So when we are talking about the topic, or when we talk about the factor called type and quantity of the cement, we have different types of cements, right? So this also will affect your strength of the concrete very drastically. More is the cement content in your concrete, there is more tendency for shrinkage cracks. Okay, when concrete is getting cured and hardened, you get more amount of shrinkage cracks. So try to reduce the cement content always. And also, various types of cement will also have an impact on your hardened concrete. You know, according to our IS 456-2000, the minimum range or the minimum cement content range is from 300 to 360 kg per meter cube. Okay? When concrete is exposed to various conditions and for various grades of concrete. And code also says that the maximum cement content is 450 kg per meter cube. IS 456-2000 will tell. And you have different grades of cement, like you have 33 grade cement in OPC, 33 you have, 43 you have, 53 you have. That grades also will affect the strength of the concrete. So what I want to tell you is the strength also depends upon the type of the cement you are using and the quantity of the cement you are using in your concrete. Next, when we talk about the factor called type and quantity of aggregate we are using. So even the strength of concrete will depend upon the strength of the aggregates also. When you use low quality aggregates, obviously your concrete will be of less strength. So you use good quality of aggregates, you get good strength. Why? Because major volume of the concrete is occupied by the aggregates only. And coming to the quantity of the aggregate, the quantity of aggregate also will show effect on hardened concrete. If your cement content is constant, say suppose we are fixing the cement content, more amount of aggregate you use, your strength will start reducing. So it's not like since aggregates are occupying more space, so I will add more aggregates. No. Everything should be in the given limits. And not only the quantity, even the size and shape of the aggregates also will play a key role in the strength that we will discuss in the next few minutes. When you talk about the quality of water, so the type of water you are mixing is also playing a role in the strength of the concrete. Always use water which are potable. So potable water are generally free from all the acids, suspended solids, etc. Though that water only should be used for making the concrete. Any other water containing impurities will show a very adverse effect on the strength of the concrete, like it may create corrosion, it may create carbonation, etc. It will reduce the life of your concrete. Next is curing. So what is curing? Curing is maintaining the temperature of the concrete so that the proper hydration will take place. So for a newly born baby, we try to wrap the baby in warm weather conditions, right? Why? Because when the baby is in the mother's womb, she or her, that baby will be habituated to the mother womb environmental condition. So when they come out, they start crying. So to maintain them, maintain the temperature of that baby, we wrap them in warm clothes. We give that warmth to that baby. Otherwise, you imagine how the situation will be. Same like our concrete. So concrete will be mixed at some temperature. It will be placed at some temperature and it will be exposed to another temperature. So you maintain enough of moisture content. You want that whatever water cement ratio you added, you want it for hydration to take place. So we do the curing. Mostly, and you have to do curing to prevent plastic shrinkage. And you have to allow the strength development to take place. And mostly, you can see here also, curing provides the desired moisture and temperature at the depth near the surface after placing and finishing. That's what I have explained. You have to, remember one point that 7 days curing will generally correspond to 70% of the strength. And on the other side, curing period will also depend upon the type of the cement and also on the nature of the work. So generally, when you are using OPC, we do curing for 7 to 14 days. Next, coming to the shape of the aggregate. So one point I would like to tell you here. So remember that use less water as possible during concrete mixing and use more water as possible for curing. Yeah, coming to the shape of the aggregate. You know there are various shapes of aggregates, right? We have angular, we have cubical, we have rounded, we have flaky, we have irregular, we have elongated, like that. We have different shapes of the aggregate. So always remember angular aggregates generally which are rough textured and rounded aggregates which are generally smooth textured, both out of which angular aggregates are always useful. Only angular aggregates can give better bonding capacity. Since if you talk about rounded aggregates, if they are round in shape, so obviously there would be more friction, there would be less friction between the constituent particles with this round shape. Just imagine aggregate to be shape in the to be in the shape of a ball. So see how ball will run easily on the ground like that. When it is rounded shape, the friction will be very less. No bonding between the cement paste. So you have to always pick angular aggregates. They give a very good binding capacity. Okay? They provide a better interlocking capacity. Even though angular aggregates do not give more workability, but they give good strength. Next, coming to the maximum size of aggregate. What is maximum size here? Generally, for coarse aggregate, we say 20 mm is the maximum size. The more bigger size of aggregates you start using, you get less strength. Why? Because larger size of aggregates will have less surface area. The area of contact of this aggregate with the surface or the concrete paste or the cement paste will be less. Hence, strength will be less. So don't go for bigger size of aggregates. Bigger size of aggregates will not give you more strength. Next comes to grading of aggregate. This is what is very important. You know, various kinds of grading are there. You have gap graded, you have uniformly graded, you have poorly graded, so you have well graded. Gap graded means if there is any one size missing in your given sample, then you say gap graded. Poorly graded means not proper retaining on all sizes, no proper retainment. Well graded means you have all sizes existing in the given sample, all sizes of coarse aggregates. Uniformly graded means all sizes of the coarse aggregates are around equal weights, like that. Always remember, we always want a well graded aggregate. A well graded aggregate will contain all sizes, and this will create less voids in the concrete. Why? Because when all sizes are there, what will happen? The voids are less. Why? Because the packing capacity of the concrete will increase, and hence the concrete will become dense, compact. So when you are giving any load, it will take more load, it will resist more load. So well graded aggregates are always preferred. Next, coming to the environmental conditions or the weather conditions. Weather conditions also affect the strength of the concrete. mostly when we talk about the cold and hot climates. In cold climate, what will happen? Concrete is subjected to freezing. And once suddenly the temperature changes, what will happen? Suddenly the weather condition changes, what will happen? The thawing will take place. So this continuous freezing and thawing action will cause failure in the concrete specimen. So with the change in moisture content, materials expand and contract. Hence, you get cracks. Next, coming to temperature, another factor called temperature. So with a certain degree of temperature increase, the rate of hydration process also will increase, thereby giving good strength. But if there is any sudden temperature change, you say that the concrete is subjected to a thermal gradient, sudden variation in temperature, which will cause cracking and spalling. So cracking means you get cracks, spalling means the bond between the reinforcement and the concrete or the surface on which the concrete is applied, the bond between the surface and the concrete will break and the concrete will fall down. That's called as spalling. So that final strength of the concrete is always lower at high temperatures. Yeah. Next, coming to another factor called rate of loading. The strength of the concrete will increase, of course, with the increasing of loading. Because at the high rates of loading, there is less time for creep. You know creep, right? Creep is what? It's the permanent deformation that is happening in a concrete structure when it is subjected to sustained loading, continuous loading. So at the early ages, the concrete is less susceptible to creeping. Hence, you'll get more strength. Next, coming to the last factor, which is age of the concrete. With increase in age of the concrete, obviously the hydration goes on increasing. More is the hydration, more is the formation of the CSH gel. Hence, more is the strength of the concrete. Okay, you know already hydration, the chemical process or the chemical reaction which is taking place between water and cement where the products of hydration are formed. So, always remember, as the days goes on, the hydration goes on and hence the strength will increase. And this is the average percentage strength we expect for the concrete placed for this particular age. So for one day we expect 16% of the entire strength for what it is designed to. For 3 days 40%, 7 days 65%, 14 days 90%, 28 days 99%, like that. Okay. Remember one more point. The concrete strength will almost get doubled after 11 years, unless until it's not subjected to any adverse conditions, adverse factors. Okay. So this is all about the factors affecting the strength. I hope I was clear. To get the notes of this video, just click on the description of this video. You'll get a link. Click on the link and download the notes. Thanks for watching.